Well, straight on to our top story this morning. Bullets flew inside the intensive care unit of a private hospital in Gurgaon as armed men barged into the ICU and opened fire at two patients who were undergoing treatment. The shootout took place at the Sunrise Hospital in Gurgaon and was captured on CCTV cameras both inside and outside the hospital. Headlines today has accessed the CCTV footage that shows around eight attackers enter the ICU of the hospital, open fire at the two patients and then just flee. The hospital staff can be seen scurrying about, and it is at that point at which the shots were fired. Hospital staff saved the life of one person in a dramatic operation, locking him in the bathroom when the assailant stormed the hospital.
लोग नहीं 10-15 लोग हैं जो सीसीटीवी फुटेज के अंदर मैं आपको दिखाऊंगा 10 से 15 लोग हमारे पास अंदर आते हैं आते ही एक आदमी ने उसमें से गन निकाली और ठक ठक कुछ नहीं पूछा क्या हो रहा है क्या नहीं हो रहा हमारे आईसीयू गार्ड को उन्होंने धक्का दिया अगर 20 लोग आके आईसीयू के गार्ड को धक्का देंगे तो वी कांट डू एनीथिंग फिर उसके बाद आईसीयू के अंदर उन लोगों ने गोलियां चलाई गई और फिर उसके बाद हम वो वहां से वो लोग फरार हो गए उसके बाद हम लोगों ने दोनों पेशेंट्स को मेडिसिटी मैदानता में रेफर कर दिया
यहाँ आने के बाद उस केस के जो आरोपी हैं उनका झगड़ा हुआ है अभी ये कह पाना संभव नहीं है किससे हुआ है लेकिन झगड़े में ये लोग घायल हुए और उन्हें यहाँ लाया गया इस अस्पताल में जब उन्हें भर्ती करवाया जा रहा था तो कुछ लोग आए और उन्होंने इन लोगों को गोली से हमला किया है घायलों को मेडिसिटी में ले जाया गया है हम बंदी मुकदमा दर्ज करके
कम से कम 20 लोग थे 22 से जानता हूँ कुछ लोगों का नाम भी लिखवा दिए मैंने ठीक है और हॉस्पिटल में जाके बसंत ने और कालू उसका लड़का है देवेंद्र का कालू के नाम से जानते हैं वैसे असली नाम हमें पता नहीं है देवेंद्र का लड़का उसके भाई का बसंत के का उन्हें जाके दोनों की गोली मारी है
कोर्ट में से तारीख वैसे आने से पहले नो ले तुमको मदद चुकाएंगे
अच्छा
फिर 15-20-25 आदमी आके मारने लगे
पिटाई की पहले आप लोग
हाँ
उसके बाद फिर आप लोग हॉस्पिटल में
हॉस्पिटल में गए सनराइज में वे सारे जाने पहुंच गए जितने लोग वहां पे थे अब दो जाने अंदर गए दोनों ने गोली मारी
This shooting incident at Gurgaon did not only shake the NCR region but also the entire country. The brazenness with which eight people barge into the ICU of this hospital and shoot at, seriously injuring a father-son duo with whom they had a feud over a piece of land, has completely shaken the entire region. These people were later shifted to the Medanta Medicity where they are critical and are undergoing treatment. The bigger question is about the ease with which these assailants came, had weapons on them and just went inside this hospital and shot at the victims. Right now, the police is saying that they have registered the case against seven people and they know who these assailants are from the CCTV footage. And right now, they have dispatched teams to locate these people and to arrest them. But the more important question right now is the state of lawlessness in Gurgaon, the Millennium City, which the Haryana government calls one of its jewels. The security situation in this entire city is worrying. This is not an isolated incident. And the police so far says they are helpless. In Gurgaon with camera person Krishan Ankit Tyagi for Headlines Today.
Well, police say the shooting was triggered by an inter-gang rivalry over a piece of land in Khansa village. There was a shootout between the two groups in Khansa in 2011. The victims, Satveer and Joginder, had gone to the Gurgaon court for the hearing in the case related to the 2011 incident. They were then attacked by the rival group again at the Gurgaon court earlier in the day and were hospitalized later. The attackers then tracked down the injured men to the hospital and shot them from point-blank range. Police are now trying to identify the attackers through the CCTV footage. But the question is, why are the victims not given any protection given the violent history of the case? Is the easy availability of firearms fueling violence in the metros? Another big question, has rampant gun culture reached Delhi's doorstep itself? Well, let's get in more from Vijay Kaur, who's tracking developments in this story. Vijay, pertinent questions that Headlines Today is raising in the wake of these developments that we saw coming to the fore in Gurgaon yesterday. Just give us a sense of the developments in the case this morning. Vijay, can you hear me? All right, we tried to establish a link with Vijay in just a bit, but obviously a big shame coming in for Gurgaon, that's known to be the jewel city for Haryana. That's the way it's positioned, and what we're talking about is this major lapse, not just in security, but the easy availability of firearms that led to this ugly, horrific incident. Well, I think Vijay is now on the phone line with us. Vijay, the sense I was trying to get from you is obviously horrific developments that we got to see yesterday. Just break down the details of where the case stands this morning, Vijay.
Well, the Gurgaon police, Nida, has indeed identified the seven assailants who had indeed entered the hospital and had attacked the other party, now the victims. Now, the Gurgaon police is trying to trace these seven people. They have already registered a case against these people under various sections, section 149, 23 and 307, which is attempt to murder, and even cases of the Arms Act 24, 54 and 59 have also been put in place. Now, Lita, basically, this only raises bigger questions about law and order situation in Gurgaon. Now, we all knew that the streets of Gurgaon were not safe, whether it is the women who were being targeted, whether it was the open firing in the courtroom, whether it was hit and run cases, like in the case of Shailesh Tete, or whether it was a hit run and dump case in case of Harish Chandra Khanduri. But now what we are seeing is that such cases have reached to the doorstep of hospitals. People are not even safe in hospitals where they're going for treatment. Now, what hospital authorities are saying that it is, and what is also very, very alarming, is the fearlessness through which these guys, these people enter the hospital. And what hospital authorities are saying, that it is common practice for people to enter with arms and ammunition inside hospitals and trying to terrorize hospital authorities, and even in this case, they terrorize the guards of the hospital. So serious questions are being raised about what the Gurgaon police is doing about the law and order situation in the whole area. Back to you, Nizam.
All right, Vijay, we'll keep coming back to you for more developments in the story. Right now, many thanks for the inputs that you have joined us with.